Obviously, to talk about an important WBA featherweight world title fight.
Okay, I'll circle back with you in a bit.
Champion Jesus Cuellar is here. He is defending against the three-division world champion in ABNER MARES. This is a terrific matchup of top-rated fighters in a deep division, featherweight division, and it is a fight that must be labeled a main event. This bout is going to open a very important broadcast for us. It is a hybrid of sorts. Calling it Showtime Championship Boxing on CBS. It's presented by Premier Boxing Champions, and it's sponsored by Corona. This type of event is not without precedent. People in Los Angeles, and I guess fans across the country, should remember in 2012, Showtime presented a day and night doubleheader, featured Leo Santa Cruz, another Southern California champion, headlining on CBS, followed by an evening presentation on Showtime with Amir Khan, all from the LA Sports Arena. But the event we're here to talk about today is on Saturday, June 25th. Again, Showtime Championship Boxing on CBS, presented by Premier Boxing Champions. It's going to be held at Brooklyn's Barclays Center, one of the premier boxing venues in the country, and a leading venue in the East, of course. The event is going to include a co-main event, another highly anticipated world championship fight between welterweights Keith Thurman and Sean Porter. Saturday, June 25th. The event is promoted by Dibella Entertainment, and here today to represent is Director of Media Relations, Kevin Rooney. Kevin, come on up.
Thank you, Chris. Just want to say on behalf of all of us at Dibella Entertainment, how truly honored and excited we are promoting this fight and this event. You know, Lou said back in New York in the Thurman presser, Porter presser, that this is the best last quarter some boxing has to offer. You know, in this fight, only he has a federation. Both of these fights are not only tremendous world title matchups, but truly two of the biggest and most exciting fights to be made in their respective division. As Chris said, taking place at the Barclays Center, the premier sporting venue on the East Coast, and live in prime time on CBS. A testament to how big this event is the way the tickets have been moving. We are hoping and anticipating some of you will be making the trip over from the West Coast. So with that being said, tickets are on sale. They start at $49 and can be purchased on Ticketmaster.com and BarclaysCenter.com. An interesting element to this fight that I don't think really has been discussed too much yet is the training aspect. Robert Garcia trained Jesus Cuellar for a good portion of his professional career. Robert Garcia and Jesus Cuellar won a world title together. Robert Garcia is here today, though, not for Jesus Cuellar. He is here with his new charge, ABNER MARES. This is the first fight that he and ABNER will be having together. They, and as many of us, believe that this is going to be the best ABNER MARES that we've ever seen. On the other side of the spectrum, while this is only the second fight with Jesus, having Juan Ledesma as his head trainer, the two have worked together since Jesus was a kid back in Argentina, and Juan is one of the highest regarded trainers throughout the entire country. On June 25th, he'll be going up against someone who he once viewed as his mentor, and we'll be excited to see how that plays out come fight day. This is our first fight working with ABNER, and we are honored to be involved with such a tremendous athlete and person. Regarding Jesus, anytime we have the chance to work with a hard-to-time fighter, given our past history at Dibella Entertainment with Sergio Martinez, it's a great prize for us. Sergio will be there on fight night, cheering and supporting his fellow countrymen on. We are excited to be close to your second consecutive world title defense. On behalf of all of us at Dibella Entertainment, I want to thank everyone for being here. We hope to see some of you guys on June 25th. Thank you.
Thanks, Kevin. Next up, we're going to bring up our fearless leader at Showtime Sports, Stephen Espinoza. Stephen began with us in 2011, and he promised us unprecedented success, either that or spectacular failure. Stephen adopted a philosophy when he began with us of, if it's worth doing, it's worth doing all the way. And that is why we're here today. We've been doing it all the way. We're in the midst right now of a 12-week run that features no less than 10 world championship fights, all live on Showtime, and in this case, two world championships on CBS, none on pay-per-view. So Stephen, come on up.
Thanks, Chris. As Chris mentioned, we're probably in the midst of the strongest run of boxing in
the 30-year history of boxing on Showtime. Obviously, the strongest lineup of any network this year. Compelling, well-matched fights, the best fighting the best. And right now, when there is some criticism of boxing, or at least it seems to be fairly common, that the best aren't fighting the best, well, all you have to do is look at this card, and you'll get your response about whether they are. These are the right fights, you know, the right weight, real weight classes, at the right time, all live to Showtime subscribers. Next week, we'll start with the super welterweight division. We've got five of the top six fighters in the division on the same card. That's the two Charlos going for title fights and a rematch of Lara versus Ambrosian. That's again, five of the top six fighters in the division on the card fighting each other. The sixth will be fighting on June 11th, by the way, in the other card there. That's Demetrius Andre. So while others are sort of wondering whether a big fight is going to happen or hoping a big fight's happened, we've been busy making the big fights. And so I get asked a lot, you know, is Floyd gonna fight again? Or, you know, will Canelo Golovkin happen? You know, I don't spend a lot of time on those kinds of questions because the reality is we've got some really good fights that are happening. You know, and it would be a shame to not focus on those, focus on the ones, like we have two great champions here who are willing to fight each other in the primes of their careers. Worry about other fights that may or may not happen. You know, on June 25th, we've got two marquee matchups. They're both top six in the division taking on each other. Thurman and Porter, we've spoken about that. I think it's probably the best matchup. And with this co-feature as well, this is really the best doubleheader of the entire year. I'll put these two fights against any doubleheader that airs on television this year. And that was our commitment when we went to CBS to do this fight. It's been almost 40 years since CBS did boxing in primetime. The last fight that CBS did in primetime was Ollie Spinks 1 in 1978. So in order to go to CBS and say this was a card that merits them getting back into the boxing business, you know we had to put on a really, really strong card. And what we did is find the two best fights that we could find and put them on back-to-back on the same card. So both of these fights, you know, Thurman Porter and Cuellar Mares, we've got fighters in the primes of their careers, you know, got the best matchup possible in the welterweight division. There's no games regarding weight classes, there's no games about people, you know, holding out for money. What we have here is just the four fighters who are willing to take on the best fighters in their division. And they don't make a whole lot of spectacle about it. They just give them the fight. So with respect to this co-main event, Cuellar versus Mares, it's one of five featherweight world title fights that we have on Showtime this year. You know, it's rapidly becoming one of my favorite divisions. And it's approaching the point back in really where the featherweight had its, maybe one of its golden ages with Barrera and Morales, and you know, at that point. So I think now with the talent that we have in the division, you know, and so far this year on Showtime, you've seen Lee Selby and Leo Santa Cruz and Gary Russell. We have Frampton moving up to the division as well. This is one of the most exciting, one of the hottest divisions in the sport. You guys all know ABNER. You've been watching him here in Southern California for quite a while. One of the best resumes in boxing. There's not that many boxers who have accomplished what he has done. He obviously is a 2004 Mexican Olympian. He's a three-division world champion. And you go down the list of fights that he's had, from Yanni Perez to Victor Chinian to Joseph Agbeko to Anselmo Moreno to Ponce de Leon to Johnny Gonzalez to Leo Santa Cruz. There's not a lot of guys who have names like that on their resume. And now he's been entertaining us for quite some while, and I'm really happy that he's going to be making his New York City debut. In New York City, we'll get to see what his fights are like. The champion, Jesus Cuellar, it's quite a put-together resume that's also very, very strong. You know, wins over Fabio Marrero, Rico Ramos, he knocked out Juan Manuel Lopez, he knocked out Victor Chinian. And what we have here is a fascinating style matchup. You know, ABNER is a classic boxer-puncher. You know, he can box, he can brawl, you get a little bit of everything. You know, the highest compliment I could pay to Jesus Cuellar is really to compare him to another recent fighter that we have featured on Showtime, and that's Marcos Maidana. This is a mini Marcos Maidana, and I'm not just saying that because he's Argentinian as well. Their styles are very similar. They've got the same level of aggressiveness. They've got the same entertainment value in the ring. So this is, you know, what I was saying, every bit as good a matchup as the main event is. The last question, and I've gotten it fairly frequently, is why put these two fights together? And again, once we made the Thurman Porter, which is, again, the best matchup in the welterweight division, we were looking for, you know, another matchup in another division that had the same level of quality. That's what we have here. We have a main event and a co-main event where it's all action, two aggressive fighters, you know, will be coming at each other in the primes of their career. It's something that I know CBS is very proud of. It's something that Showtime is very proud of. And I can't wait until June 25th. Thank you.
Thank you, Stephen. As Kevin mentioned, Lou DiBella couldn't be here today, but I wish he was, because back in New York when Thurman and Porter got together, he mentioned, and he was referencing Abner and Cuellar in this important featherweight fight, that these two fights are the best that boxing has to offer. To echo what Stephen had said, all four of these fighters are consensus top 10 ranked in their divisions, and they don't back down from a challenge. And they do so with class and dignity, and truly represent our sport on a global stage in a way that makes me proud to be associated with boxing. So thank you guys. So without further ado, I'm going to bring up the fighters. Abner Morris, he is 29-2 with one draw. He has 15 knockouts. Abner's been fighting on Showtime for a long time. He's been winning on Showtime since 2010, including a victory in the bantamweight tournament that we had in 2010-2011. Stephen mentioned some of the names on his resume. Abner never fails to face the biggest challenges in his division. He had three different weight divisions as champion already. And as I said, he's always done so with class outside the ring and with a ferocity rarely seen inside the ring. So Abner, why don't you come up and say a few words, please.
Good afternoon, everyone. Really, really, really happy to be fighting, to be part of this, part of my men, against a tough fighter. I know he's mentioned a few times that he's been wanting to fight me, and I finally came out, and I'm not scared to fight him. You know, there's always time for a prayer, and back when he wanted to fight me, it wasn't his time. Now it's time for him to face me, and he's going to know when he has to fight a top-level fighter. As mentioned, I've been in boxing for many years. I fought many, many tough fights. Coming from one, actually, I just fought Leo Santa Cruz, a tough fight. But definitely, I mean, the outcome wasn't the best one, the one we wanted, but it was a tough fight. And a fight where we showed that we have the heart, we have the intelligence, we have everything. You know, it was a tough fight against a tough fighter. And now we have a Jesus Cuellar, who's a tough fighter, a guy who lives, a guy who I respect, but as a fighter, as a person, I have nothing bad to say about him. But other than that, I just have to tell them to get ready. He can be in the highest mountain. I know he's training big. He can train in the highest mountain, which is competition. It's not I'm still a level fighter. I'm a level fighter. I'm going to show me. Thank you guys so much. I'm really excited to be fighting in Brooklyn, actually, in New York, for the very first time. I'm excited. We're taking this as a family trip. Fighting, become the world champion, and after that, we go sightseeing with the family. So I'm excited, I'm really happy. Thank you for the family this year. My friends, press, you know, I'm happy to be working with Robert Garcia now. You know, we're taking this fight really, really serious. It's a fight that I'm going to gain so much, and Robert too, you know, as a team. As he wants to work with this player, and I think he's going to show him. With me, as an example, it was a big mistake. Thank you so much. Bless you.
Okay, Abner, so some of the background noise you may have heard there was Sebastian Contorsi translating for Jesus to make sure he understood what was being said, so no disrespect there. Jesus Cuellar, as you know, out of Argentina, is training up in Big Bear. He has 28 wins and one loss. He has 21 big knockouts. Jesus is making the second defense of a title that he won from Vic Darchinian by devastating knockout, and recently defended that title in December of 2015 on Showtime on the undercard of Danny Jacobs versus Peter Quillen. And that was in a terrific fight, a unanimous decision win over Jonathan Mackindo. If you include the interim titles that Jesus has owned, he's been a champion since 2013. So without further ado, I'd like to bring up Sebastian to help translate, and Jesus Cuellar.
Good afternoon to everyone.
Bueno, nada, se dio una gran pelea, la pelea que estaba buscando para crecer un poco más. Sé que estoy entrenando con mi equipo, uno de los mejores, y nada, creo que el 25 de julio se va a ver bien la calidad de boxeo que tengo.
I've been training hard for this fight. You'll see in June the 25th that I have one of the best teams out there. And I'm glad to final this fight tonight.
Estoy muy contento con mi equipo. Estamos trabajando muy duro. Ya hace dos meses y medio estamos en Milver. Y nada, gracias por todo. Gracias a la cadena de Showtime, CBC. Y a AGM para por todo lo que pasa en el mundo.
We've been training out of Bigger for a little more of 2 months now. So I'm glad I'm training hard for this fight. I want to thank you all and thank CBS Showtime for this opportunity and also to ABNER.
El 25 de junio voy a estar preparado para dejar todo en el ring. Una vez más voy a levantar mi brazo en alto y voy a demostrar quién es el campeón.
On June the 25th, once again, I will give it all and we'll leave it all in the ring and I will raise my hands once again and I will prove the champions.
Muchísimas gracias a todos.
Thank you very much to everyone.
Like you said, no trash talk, no BS, all respect for these guys, and they just bring it when they get into the ring. So I think face off between the gentlemen, and then break out into one-on-ones. Come on up, Abner. Hey, Jesus. And then we'll bring up
Oh, sorry. Sorry.
Vamos, mi gallo.
Is that okay for you?
Look down at these guys first, right here. Down on the front. Okay. Ready? Ready with the glasses. There. Okay. Puratero.
And then
look
up. The TV
cameras. Hands up.
Steven, come on up.
Devin Rennie. Where's Kevin Rennie?
Yep.
Tell him to come up here. Where's the trainer? Robert.
Kevin, come on up.
Thank you.
And Robert, yeah. And Sebastian. Especially your trainer, I'm sorry. Pardon me, please. Sorry, pardon me.
Yeah, perro. What's up, perro?
There you go. There you go. That's a good one.
Okay, 3, 2, 1. Thank you, guys.
Thank you. Okay, so we're going to do it. I'm going. Thanks.
Good luck.
Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good luck. Good lu